Salutations, everyone. This is Razor here giving you some domination gameplay on the
Capture
map
the
Studio.
objective.
Fuck it. It's firing range.
Securing
You all
C.
know what it is. It's firing range. I
Objective
don't care what
secured.
they want to call it. We're always going to call it firing range. We're going to use the same old callouts as always.
Securing
Fucking
Bravo.
triple C4. What you know about that?
Securing A.
Yeah, that's
Locked
just
down.
kind of what I do. Get shot in the back there. But, you know, it's whatever. It's whatever. It's water under the bridge. I won't hold it against that guy for killing me. On the map that I was born in, the map I lost my virginity in, the map that I rule and have ruled for the past three fucking years, I like Fire Range. It's a map that I enjoyed a lot in the very first Black Ops, and that I haven't seen too many changes to this map. There are some, but for the most part, when it comes to how you play the game, it's largely the same. So I don't think I need to, you know, let you guys know about any of the changes or lines of sights or nade spots, but don't worry, I'm sure TMart will make six fucking videos about it. Especially since everyone did the work for him 2 years ago, so that's something to look forward to. The spawn logic has been changed a little bit. See, one of the great things about the Black Ops 1 firing range is that the spawns were very predictable, but they never put the enemies, you know, closer to you to where you could, you know, shoot them as they spawn, or they spawn right behind you and there's nothing that you can do. Fire range is a small enough map in that you have to have a fast enough reaction time or you're gonna get shot. But it also has plenty of defensive positions and different spawn locations that won't put you immediately in harm's way, like, ever. You know, unless you got people camping with TAC inserts or such. And you're going to see a lot more people camping in this firing range or studio, whatever they want to call it, whatever you guys want to call it. A lot more people will be camping, especially with sniper rifles. And, you know, since we don't have the good old snipers from Black Ops 1, the snipers in Black Ops 2, as everyone knows, are a lot easier to use than the snipers from Black Ops 1. So a lot more people are going to be camping with them, looking down towards the firing range where I'm headed right here. A lot of people will be camping right here, waiting for people to come with sniper rifles. People will be camping the ramp and as well as camping down by the A flag. So expect a lot more camping with sniper rifles, you know, just because of, you know, we have much easier to use snipers in this game. Shoot that guy, his tech insert's gone. Fucking, I'm just picking up weapons left and right because I was using the SCAR here with no attachments and I still haven't unlocked Scavenger. So picking up this Remington, picking up this AN-94, so it's all good. And I got my score streaks. I'm going to use them for the first time here on the new firing range. Going to start with the Lodestar. I don't know how many people were on the enemy team, but there weren't very many to kill. Unfortunately, they spawned right next to my body, so there's one of my five deaths right there. I'm just taking these guys out in a score streak that we didn't have in the first Black Ops, so that's pretty cool. And then I'll hop up in the chopper gover equivalent of the game. Outside of the fucking triple kill through the window there, fucking nerds hiding in the trailer, one of the differences from studio to firing range is the spawn logic isn't quite as good as you would expect from Black Ops 2, but also the trailer, they reinforce. The trailer is 100% bulletproof. I don't know about if you use FMJ, but because I don't have FMJ on most of my classes, but the trailer is bulletproof now. You can't shoot through it with any regular old gun. Like I said, I haven't tested it with FMJ, but you can't shoot through it with any gun, regardless. So that really sucks. They're, you know, improving camping mechanics in this game. They're encouraging more people to camp. And that trailer is one of the hardest ones to get people out of because of these small windows that they have. And now that the fact you can't shoot through them at all really sucks. At first I thought the wood you wouldn't be able to shoot through, because it looks like a castle, but it's really just plywood, like a set from a studio. So that's a little deceiving, but you can still shoot through top wood and bottom wood. And that's also one of the cool things about you're bringing us this firing range. And here's something that's not used to on firing range, host migrations. Because in Black Ops 1 and Modern Warfare 2 and COD 4 and World at War, they picked good hosts. And they didn't just give it out to everyone willy-nilly and change it every single game. So there's something that's going to be different on firing range from now on. More, you're going to see more host migrations and dash borders. The first time I played Studio when I was with a bunch of FaZe members, we were actually going up against some really try-harded people who wanted to win and wanted to play the game. They were playing the objective and shit. And they fucking dashboarded right after the second round started. So a lot more people are going to be taking this map seriously than before. But that's not going to stop me from just shooting faces up, throwing my C4s. It's kind of awkward, especially at the beginning of the games, that I don't have Simtex, because back in Black Ops 1, I would run C4 and Simtex, because you can do that. Because tactical and lethal equipment was different. And so usually on firing range, I throw that spawn Simtex. I wouldn't cap A or C, and I would throw a Simtex and take everyone off A or take everyone off of C. You can still get a spawn C4 off of A flag, but not if everyone jumps on it. So you're going to have to either be quick with like a lightweight marathon class to pull that up. But get stuck by Simtex. Hate getting stuck by Simtex because it's like there's nothing you can do about it, and you know you're gonna die, but you haven't died quite yet. That's really annoying. Also, a lot more people are gonna be camping in the crow's nest. A lot more people are camping in the crow's nest, and it's gonna be a much more popular camping spot, and a much harder to get people out of camping spot. Since Ghost isn't as prevalent in Black Ops 2 as it is in Black Ops 1, so more people run flak jackets, so that makes explosives difficult to kill people out of the crow's nest. But what are you going to do? I'm still going to be dropping 50-plus kill gameplays on the regular, just like the good old days. So hope you guys enjoyed it. A comment is always appreciated, and I'll see you next time.